Hello friends, today we are meeting with a new topic, gender status indicators. So this is very important and interesting topic about indicators pertaining to gender. Myself, Sudeshna Lahiri, and I am Associate Professor in Department of Education, University of Calcutta. And welcome again at NIUS Studio with DLET program. So before we start, let's discuss about what is indicator is all about. An indicator is a pointer. It can be a measurement, a number, a fact, an opinion, or a perception that directs attention to a specific condition or situation. It measures changes in that condition or situation. The term indicator comes from the Latin indicator, indicare, which means to point out, to focus around. It is common to describe an indicator as a pointer or sign of change, a measure, number, fact, opinion, or perception that points at a specific condition or situation whose change is examined over time So it may be a number or it may be a narrative. So gender indicator is also having some kind of features. So indicators provide a close look at the results of initiatives and actions. The difference between an indicator and statistics is that using indicators should involve comparison with a norm. So indicators are not one and all. It should have some frame of reference. And a statistics is also involves some kind of norm, but it has a reference. So today, again, we will discuss some features of status indicator. Indicators provide a close look at the results of initiatives and actions. The difference between an indicator and a statistics is that using indicators should involve comparison with a norm. For example, if we are taking a statistics, that is in percentage, it compares with 100, which is any number. But when we talk about indicators, it always compare with some reference, and that may be a norm. Gender-based status indicators can refer to quantitative indicators based on sex-deaggregated statistical data, which provides separate measures for men and women on various walks of life, for example, literacy and education. Indicators provide a measurable means of monitoring and evaluating a measure's goal, objective, outputs, and activities. So for collecting and deducing into indicators, there are two main approaches: the quantitative approach and qualitative approach. Quantitative method of data collection produce quantifiable result. So they focus on issue which can be counted. So it is in numbers or numeral. Qualitative approach of deducing into indicators, it has qualitative methodologies which capture people's experiences, opinions, attitudes, and feelings. This may be in terms of narratives. For example, women's experience of constraints or advantage of working in informal sector, or women's experience in legislation, women's experience in parliament, women's experience in pursuing higher education. The method involves in qualitative approaches are focus group discussion and social mapping tools, and which are used to collect the data for qualitative indicators. Qualitative data can also be collected through surveys measuring perceptions and opinions. Why status indicators are required for gender discrimination, gender empowerment, and all the construct under gender? The status indicator for gender and gender discrimination is required to collect evidences so that the issues can be prioritized. The status indicators are to enable better planning and actions, can be used for holding institutions accountable for their commitments on gender equality, can help to stimulate change through data collection processes. Challenges to decide status indicators and its measurement, because it is very challenging. What are the indicators and the tools for measurement of these indicators and its decision? While measuring change through indicators, it is not only a technical exercise but also a contextual process. You have to know what is the context where this indicator has been measured. It may be differing from society wise, it may be differing from geography wise, and it may be different from and for and with nation wise. The data may not be sufficient and thus dismiss the indicator. It is quite difficult to know the reason behind the indicator and the change, because indicator is always talking about what is, because it is showing the status. So why it is so and how it is so, it doesn't talks about it. How does status indicator decide it? A range of international measurement instruments are decided across recognized goals and indices. So sometimes there are pre-decided measurement instruments which are decided by various research institutes and different centers who are working over these gender indices. Data must be collected, analyzed, disseminated, and to be used to decide upon indicator. Combination of it is the combination of qualitative and quantitative methods should be considered. Now, what are the gender indicators? Gender indicators are established to measure and compare the situation of women and men over time. Gender indicators can refer to quantitative indicators collected from quantitative approach, and these are based on statistics broken down by sex, for example, male and female, number of enrollment, male and female, or two qualitative indicators based on women's and men's experiences, attitude, opinions, and feelings. Quantitative and qualitative indicators must enable ongoing monitoring and evaluation. Gender-sensitive indicators, which are known as GSI popularly, allow measuring changes in the relations between men and women in regards to a certain policy area, a specific program or activity, or changes in status or situation of women and men. Gender indicator can be further decided as gender-sensitive indicators can be described in terms of the derived quality to be reached, the quantity of something to be achieved, the target group who is affected by or benefited from the project, the time frame envisaged for the achievement of the objectives. While the gender blind indicators typically attempt to measure variables such as group participation and involvement of community, so these are not talking about the representation of women or differential representation of gender. Gender-sensitive indicators highlight changes in gender relations in society over time. So, sometimes male and female, they are differentially in quotes the indicator. And by location, that is to say, measuring whether gender equality is being achieved. The reason to decide upon status indicator for gender. So, there are several reasons to decide upon status indicator. What changes needed to be seen? Defining the vision of change, determining the indicators and gathering data. What legal frameworks exist that may enable or inhibit gender equality? What information already exists or is being collected to assist in tracking changes? How can there be an assurance small changes will be measured? How will the data collected be analyzed and disseminated? Where status indicator of gender is required, because we have to decide in which situation the status indicator is required or not. Similarly for researches also, where status indicator is required or not, whether we are using gender blind indicator or gender sensitive indicator for a particular research or a particular survey. So gender sensitive indicators are needed in order to measure progress towards target, which themselves need to be gender sensitive. And also a prerequisite for the establishment of gender sensitive indicator is the availability of statistical data disaggregated by sex and other more qualitative types of information reflecting differences between women and men. Gender sensitive indicators, which is GSI, require the production of data that is disaggregated by sex, age, ethnicity and other socio-economic variables relevant to the project or programming context, by pointing to changes in gender relations in the society over time. GSIs support gender mainstreaming in planning and implementation, and more importantly in monitoring evaluation of activities. So let's take Millennium Development Goal as an example and how gender status indicator work across different goals. We know that MDG or Millennium Development Goal is having 8 core goals. And these 8 core goals, how the gender status indicator or status indicator for gender can be incorporated across the goals. Let's take goal number 1, eradicate extreme poverty and hunger. So what may be the indicators? Equal access for women to basic transport and energy infrastructure. So if we see the status indicator, we can ensure under this goal number 1, equal access for women. Similarly, with the help of status indicator, under goal number 1, there may be investment in women's health and nutritional status. The goal number 2 is achieving universal primary education. So with the help of status indicator, the education of women will be ensured. School enrollment and attainment, this equity for girl child will be ensured. Under goal number 3, which is promoting gender equality and empowering women, this is very important, and we can see with the help of status indicator that ratios of girls to boys in primary, secondary, tertiary education. So different planned programs can be framed and formed. Similarly, gender equality and women empowerment. This is one more status indicator, and again different planned programs at government and in federal, state and also international diaspora can be framed and formed. Share of women in wage employment in the non-agricultural status. With this status indicator, the share of women can be the equal share and the equitable share can be ensured. Proportion of seats held by women in parliament, this can also be ensured when we are having status indicator. Goal 4, which is reducing child mortality. So, mothers' education, income and empowerment, lowering child mortality, it can be seen and prioritized through status indicator. Then goal number 5, to improve maternal health, and this important issue of mother's education, income and empowerment can also be ensured and decided by status indicator. Goal number 6, to combat HIV or AIDS, malaria and other diseases. So gender status indicator can decide and can determine the economic independence of women, ability to negotiate safe sex. Goal number 7, which is to ensure environmental sustainability. Again, if we see the gender status indicator, gender equitable property and resource ownership policies enable women to ensure its status in the society, government and community. Goal number 8, and it says to develop a global partnership for development. Again, the gender status indicator can ensure gender equality in political sphere. Now there are some quantitative and qualitative status indicator for gender. We will discuss one by one. Quantitative status indicator for gender. Sources of quantitative indicators are data systems and records where information is presented in sex disaggregated manner. Sources include censuses, labor force surveys, administrative records or sociological surveys for the target population. Quantitative indicators tend to be easier to define, record and assess than qualitative indicators. Similarly, there are qualitative indicators for gender, and that can be defined as people's judgments and perception of a given subject. They are useful for understanding processes, but frequently do not show how typical or widespread the views expressed are. They are harder to measure as they involve processes and use categories of classification such as those based on perception. Gender status indicator are having 3 important levels. So indicator can be measured in 3 levels, that can be at macro level, that can be at meso level, and that can be at micro level. So at macro level, indicators are used to measure the following gender equality issues at the larger scale social process, for example, national and international level politics. Meso level, this level is somewhere between macro and micro level. So indicator at this level are needed in order to measure somewhere between macro and micro level, for example, when data is taken from community or organization. Micro level indicator at this level are needed in order to measure at small scale. So today we have learnt about the status indicator pertaining to gender, and we discussed about the definition of status indicator and how the gender and its different concepts and construct required the status indicator. And we also differentiated 2 types of status indicators on the basis of qualitative approach of measurement and quantitative approach of measurement. How we collect data and arrive at indicator. Similarly, on the basis of the level of data collection, we have decided upon macro level, meso level and micro level of indicators. We have also discussed how the 8 core goals of Millennium Development Goal and how at every level we need status indicator for gender to decide upon some very important and crucial concerns pertaining to gender. So that is how and why the status indicator exists, and important and very interesting. So next day, with the next time, we will meet with a new topic. Thank you.